You know, Craig, I'm always interested when I teach history at how erroneous the ideas were that we had for so many, many centuries about the causes of disease. And the consequences of that were severe because our treatments were.
Oh, yeah. People had no idea what was going on with what caused disease, and therefore just about any treatment under the sun was applicable to it. They used mercury to treat a lot of diseases, so if the disease didn't get you, the mercury poisoning did. Just used a lot of crazy things. Bloodletting to remove the evil spirits. I wonder how many people exsanguinated during their treatment experience. You know, it even affected George Washington later in life when it was utilized to try and treat him.
So what happened and when did it happen that changed our view of this pretty recently, as I understand?
Yeah, so it really started in the 1600s when microscopes were discovered, and Robert Hooke and Antonio von Leeuwenhoek discovered microorganisms in bacteria, but that idea lied fallow for another 100-plus years until people began to realize that something might be up with these microbes. And it really wasn't until Louis Pasteur in the mid-1800s began to investigate their role in various biological reactions that people got an idea that they could even be the cause of disease. So that's the beginning of germ theory.
So not only did we have to discover the microbes, but we had to begin to understand that they were causing the problem. So what happened? Where's the nexus there that occurred?
Well, I think you really have to look at Robert Koch, the famous German physician and microbiologist. He's the one that really advanced this idea by developing what are now known as Koch's postulates, a way to determine the actual cause of a specific disease. And he's the one that proved beyond a shadow of a doubt that diseases like bubonic plague were caused by a specific bacteria. In fact, today we still use Koch's postulates routinely to look at what the cause of new diseases are.
I'm fascinated by this because when you think across the course, as I do as a historian of history, how bad our ideas were and the consequences of that, and of course our course gets involved in a lot of why those bad ideas caused massive death, literally bad ideas causing death. So not just the microbes, but how stupid we were.
Yeah, I think, you know, for the lay person today to really look back historically, it's only been in that last window of 100 years when we really understood what causes diseases. And you can historically see that without that understanding, people were everywhere blaming everybody, the Jewish scapegoats for the bubonic plague in the 1300s and so forth. So fortunately, since then, we have the tools, we have the understanding, and now things like Ebola, Lassa fever, SARS, when they come out rapidly using these methods developed in the last 100 years, we're able to discover the cause of that disease and try to determine effective treatments and preventative methods.
Now, incidentally, Craig has written an essay, don't be scared by the word, but has written quite a nice summary of what the microbiologists think these days about disease and how this all evolved. And we really encourage you to take a look at that in addition to listening to this little introduction to the subject.